Hey everyone, it's time for us to entertain a modification that we can make to the EIGRP stub configuration that's going to involve the use of a leak map. Now, I want to kill two birds with one stone in this particular presentation because what we have here is notice that I have R5. And we know that R5 is the transit for the loopbacks of 172.16.19.0.24, 172.16.19.20.0.24, and 172.16.21.0.24. Now, when we look at this, we're going to do our testing from R22, and what I want to do is I'm going to find out what path this particular stream of data is going to take in my topology. And the best way to do that is to simply do a trace route. So we'll trace route to 172.16.19.19. And what we see is that traffic is going from 22 to 3 to 2, Cat 2, to R5, and then up to the respective devices. Now, here's one of the things that I want to look at. I want to change R5 such that the tunnel interface that we are going to be using, tunnel 0, is going to be configured as a stub. Now, the only thing I'm going to advertise is connected. Now, what we're going to find is that's going to break our network. So let's look at that. So first of all, we see that I can reach 1919, let's say 2020, and 2121. And we've got all the reachability that we need. Now, let's modify this. Let's go to R5, and I'm going to say config T interface tunnels, I'm sorry, router EIGRP 10, and I'm going to say EIGRP stub connected. So the only thing that I'm going to advertise are prefixes that I have physical connections to. So as you can see, it's cleared our connections, everything's coming back up. And the main point at this juncture is that I want to go to R22 and see now if I have reachability. So rather than doing a trace route, I'm just going to use a ping. So I'm going to say ping 172.16.19.19. I have no reachability. Now I'm going to find I have nothing for 20 or 21. And the reason being is that R5 is only advertising its connected interfaces. So let's do something here. Let's see what's happening. So can I ping 172.16.5.5? Yes, I can. And can I ping the physical connection going to my DMVPN configuration? Let's do that. Let's come over here and say ping 10.10.10.5. I have reachability. Can I ping 19? It's not going to let me go. So what's happening is R5 is only advertising EIGRP updates for its connected interfaces. Now, this isn't necessarily something that we want to have happen, but it does illustrate the point that I can take any device in my topology and make it a stub, recognizing the fact that by default, traffic is never going to traverse across that stub device. Now, obviously, we're going to look at how we can change this, and I want to put a stipulation in place. My first stipulation in place is that I only want to allow R5 to advertise the loopbacks. So let's write this in. So I want it only to advertise the loopbacks of R19, 20, and 21. So I want to leak those. And the way that I'm going to leak them is I'm going to use a leak map. Now let's look at how that's going to be configured. So on R5, we see almost immediately here, do show run section router. And we see that we are a stub connected configuration, which is exactly what we just configured. Now, what I want to do is I want to change that. I'm going to say router EIGRP 10. I'm going to say EIGRP stub connected, and I want to use a leak map, and I'm going to call this leak map just TST for test. All right, now let's see what happens. Let's go over to R22. Do I have reachability now? Let's just pick another one. Let's say to 172.19.19. Can I reach it? Nope, I can't. So let's do this. Let's go back over to R5. And on R5, I want to create a way to match prefixes. So let's see. I am going to say that I want to match using an access list. Let's say access list 1. Let's see, do I have one first? Do show access list. So access list 1. I'm going to say permit. And I'm going to say 172.16.19.0. Wildcard mask, I'm going to just say 24. Nah, I always mess that up. Sorry. Space, 24. I want to say match on 20. And lastly, I'm going to say match on 21. Do show access-list. Now we see all three of those, and it's matching on these networks. Now what I want to do is I'm going to create that route map. I'm going to say route-map. I'm going to say leak routes permit 10. I'm going to say match IP address, and I want to match specifically on access list 1. And let's see what happens. Clear IP EIGRP neighbors. All right, adjacencies are back up. Let's try this. Show IP access-list. Well, I'm not matching on anything. Well, let's look at this. Show run section router. So we are leak map. We're using TST. Show route-map TST. And I don't have that route map. What did I call that? Did I call that something else? Leak routes, that's what I called it. So here, I'll just modify it this way instead of rewriting all of that. I will say router EIGRP 10. EIGRP stub connected leak map, and what I want to use is I want to use this one. Do show run section router. And notice I'm using this. Now let's see if we match anything. Do show access-list, and now I'm actually matching prefixes. So if I go over to R22, now do I have reachability? Well, I'm matching, but the question is what am I matching? So I don't have anything there. Let's see if there's anything in the routing table. Let's say show IP route 172, 19, 20, and 21. Well, that's interesting. So the question is, I mean, they're appearing in my table, but the question now is, what's going on R19? Well, let's take a look at R19. Show IP route. Hey, look here. I have no idea where R22 is. The only thing I know about is going to be 192 or 172.16.5.5. I'm going to know about 2020. I'm going to know about 21. Whoops. Used the wrong one. Should be 2121. 2121. Can I ping 10.1, let's say 222. Actually, it'd be 223.222. I don't know anything about those prefixes. So what I did is I leaked prefixes that I have that I'm actually seeing coming in towards the rest of the network. But now what I need to do is I need to link the prefixes that I want to use to be able to resolve reachability to the objects or the devices in my DMVPN cloud. So this is getting pretty interesting. So how do I do that? Well, when we look at how we did our leaks, let's take a look at this. Let's say show IP route EI or show IP show run section router. And what do we see? Well, right now on R19, we don't see anything. Let's take a look at R5. All right, well, we're leaking routes, but here's the problem. Show access dash list, or do show access dash list. These are the only prefixes that we're leaking. Well, if I want to have reachability from R22, I need to be able to leak how to get to R22. So let's take a look at the interface on R22. So let's say show IP interface brief. And what do we see? I have 222.222 and 223.222. So let's go over to R5 and leak those. So it's going to be access list one permit. And what else am I going to leak? Well, I'm going to say that I want to permit 10.1.222.222, or we'll say 0/24. Exit. And I want to leak 223.24. Now let's look and see what's going on. Show access dash list. Clear EIGRP neighbors. Well, notice it changed already. I didn't even have to do it. So let's see what's going on now. Let's take a look at that access list. Access, show access list. Now notice I'm actually leaking these prefixes. So now if I go over to R19 and type show IP route, now I should see those two prefixes coming through. So here they are. So now let's see if I have reachability. So we'll go back over to R22 and we'll do a test. Let's just repeat our ping. 1919. Notice that we are working. Let's do a trace route. 2172.16.19.19. R3, CAT2, R5 to 19. Now what if I source it from a loopback interface? So let's say source LO0. Well, let's see. Trace route. I need to do it. Let's do a ping. Ping 172.16.19.19. Ping works. Source it from LO0 and no. Loopback 100, that's what I'm looking for. Yeah. So notice it did a source address of 172.16.222.222. Now the reason it's not working is if I go over to 19, do I see a 117.16.222? No, I do not. All I see is 10.1. So if I wanted to allow that to work, I would be able to come in here and say config T, type in access list permit 2220, enter, do show access dash list. Oh, I did 10 again. So I need 172. 172.16.222, do show access dash list. There's the entry. It will ultimately recycle. There it is. And now if I do my show access list, I can see I have matches for this one. So now if I go over to R22 and do my ping, sourcing it from loopback 0, now I have reachability. Now I want to entertain another element here. And that is the fact that I want to have the ability to be able to do reachability or do, I want everyone to be able to ping, or I want all of these DMVPN sites to be able to ping every interface but loopback 100 on R22. So let's modify our access list. So what we'll do is we'll cut over to R5. And I'm going to say no access list 1. I'm going to say access list 1 deny, and I want to deny 172.16.2.2.2.0/24, and I want to deny, let's see, that's going to, that's all I want to do. I don't want anybody in the DMZ, or I'm sorry, in the DMVPN network to be able to reach 172.16.2.2.2. Now, in order to be able to assure that, I need to create an IP access list for a permit any IP, access list 1, permit any. Do show access dash list. All right, let's see what's going on now. So I have an explicit deny and I have an explicit permit. And let's see if it causes my sync, my link to reset, which it did. Because remember, this takes effect. So let's do show access dash list. Now I have my permits. So now if I roll over here and I go to, say, R19, show IP route, do I see a link to 172.16.2.2.2? No, I do not. Can I ping it? 172.16.2.2.2.2.2. I can't reach it. Nor will I have reachability to any of these other devices. Show IP route. No, 222. It ends at 212. And lastly on 21. And ping 172.16.2.2.2.2.2. Now the question is, can I ping any of these others? So for instance, can I ping 2.2? Yes. Can I ping .2 sourcing it from my own loopback address? Yes. What happens if I go over on R1 and create a new interface? Config T, let's see, not on R1, on R22. Interface LO101. IP address 172.16.2.2.3.2.2.2. Let's go over to R19. Show IP route. Notice it appears and I have reachability to it. So ping 172.16.2.2.3.2.2.2. So go ahead and source it from my own loopback. If I had a nickel for every time I misspelled ping, I'd be a billionaire by now. So we have reachability. So all this does is illustrate how I can use leak maps in concert with the stub to be able to overcome issues associated with having to place the stub, if I'm instructed to, in the context of the CCIE Routing and Switching version 5 lab in the middle of my topology. So bear in mind, if you're told to configure a stub, but you still have to maintain reachability, one of my ideal candidates for you to be able to do that is going to be to configure the leak map in concert with the stub configuration. With that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video where we're going to start talking about more concepts with regard to prefix filtering. So I'll see you there. Bye-bye.